I enjoyed myself.
In the studio.
Oh. 5191. It's your boy DJ SlyFox. Right there. Got my RB3000 with me. What's going on, sir?
Yeah.
And we about to trivialize some people today. If that's a word, I doubt it.
Shout out to Jimmy Swaggy.
Ooh, one of my guys. Talk about pop culture. You know some stuff. All right, guys. Tonight. Am I recording? Yes, I am. Okay. Tonight we are going to be doing 80s and 90s pop culture. So let's get the rules in play real quick. We got a couple of folks that I have not seen in here before. So I want everybody to get to know how we do things. First line of business. I'm going to put it on speaker. I'm going to put it on full screen. First line of business is everybody know where their reaction button is. Hopefully we can get to that. That is how we score in here. That's how we keep track of points and who's on the board. So if you can get that reaction button, if everybody that knows how to do it can show them a reaction button, put the hands up. There you go, Carmen. Carmen got the thumbs up. The only thing with the Carmen, there you go. If you put the thumbs up, it doesn't move your stuff to the front of the screen. First one I see at the front of the screen is the first person I call. So make sure you do the raise hand button. All right, cool. I'm gonna raise my hand too. I'm in that thing. All right. Now, hold on, Unique, you try to hand raise me.
You gotta raise the hand, Joe.
Yeah, that's the one right there. All right, cool. Well, let me get my board set, and I gotta write a couple more names on here.
Nice. When you want to answer, you raise the hand.
We got
Jason Michael didn't light a cigarette and pour his drink yet, huh?
Oh, he got a cigarette in his drink right there, dog.
Oh, shit.
It's going down.
It's going down already. All right, let's see. Let's see what we got here. Mr. RB3000, you ready to do this thing, man?
We got it.
All right, you know how I do it. If you got one that piggybacks off of one I've said, by all means, cut in, put it in. Let's make
I'm standing on the side waiting to jump in like a double dutch.
Oh, man. All right.
You know how to double dutch?
Who asked him if you know how to double dutch? Of course you know how to double dutch. You know who he is?
Man, you saw the A-Man video I put up on there. That's how I learned how to do it.
Yeah! Right.
See, we can afford to do a little talking right now because ain't nobody got no points yet. But boy, I tell you, when somebody get like a 5-point lead, they be like, hey, come on, man.
Shut up.
All right, let's do this.
More questions.
Let's talk it. More questions. All right, I'm gonna go with the first one. We're gonna start with no, fuck the subtopics. I put in the post what all the topics are gonna be, so it's gonna be random AF. Okay. First question: What character? Listen to what I said. What character said, "Do you understand the words that are coming out of my mouth?" And Jason Michael? You're muted.
I was just hovering my finger. I must have touched it, my bad.
Oh, no problem. All right. Jason G.
Oh, shit. I don't know the character's name. I know it's Chris Tucker from Rush Hour.
Don't get no hits.
We gotta save
it. That'll be time. All right. We're going to go with Unique. Unique, unmute yourself. What you got?
Chris Tucker off of Rush Hour.
That is incorrect. And I'll tell you why in a minute. Carmen, what you got?
Agent Carter.
Okay. All right. So, Carmen, that is a correct answer. Unfortunately, that was not the.
Is it a correct answer?
That is Agent Carter.
Especially, I thought his name was James Carter.
Look, Agent Carter is fine.
Inspector Lee said it too. Is that a right answer?
Well, that is a right answer because I didn't finish my question. So,
oh, you didn't finish the question.
I did not finish my question, so I stopped because the hands went up. So, Carmen, you did get on the board. Carmen, you did get on the board. I'm putting these hands down so I can finish the question. You guys chime in. All right. So, to finish my question, do you understand the words that are coming out the mouth? And what movie? All right, damn, y'all let Carmen get back in there. Carmen, what you got?
Rush Hour, man.
All right, you got it. Carmen got 2 points, y'all. Carmen's first on the board. You're only on the board.
Let's see how this gonna go.
I have a question.
What you got?
So if the hand goes up, you acknowledge the hand, or do you finish the question and then
acknowledge? I acknowledge the hand. If I see, because I'm reading, okay. I try to stop the question in the tracks.
Okay. I got a question.
Oh, go ahead.
Why she need to know? She only have to let her raise her hand on.
I mean, maybe she's asking
it was a question
else.
In my mind. I thought it might be a question in someone else's mind.
I can mute. It's not that bad.
Maker's Mark, limited edition, 101 proof.
That's the one.
I seen it.
All right, look, I'm with it. Carmen, look, she came to play. She got her hair tied. Well, she ready. All right, let's go. Next question. What character said, "I see dead people," and in Jason Michael?
Billy.
That is incorrect.
God damn.
Laughing. Don't laugh at somebody's answer. Farrah.
I know the movie. His name was
Billy.
No, it wasn't Billy, but the movie was Sixth Sense. I don't know the name.
All right. Well, Farrah, default just got a point because I did not finish the question, but that was the second part of the question. So, Farrah, you got 1 point for that.
Because I got my phone in front of my computer.
Put these hands down real quick. I'm going to put these hands down.
I'm going to just watch this.
I know the character's name.
I got to ask the question again. Don't put your... Not too late now. I got to ask the question again. Then after I finish now, since we done did the first part, I'll see the hands. All right.
That's why I think you should finish, even
that's
though they raised their hands.
Because then they're cheating. That gives other people time to go Google this stuff.
No, you already see who raised their hand, but you tell them, hey, I'm acknowledging you. Well, hold on, let me finish the question.
Check this out. I'm going to tell you why I don't do that. I've done it before. Go ahead, RB.
I just want y'all to know he's nicer than me because if y'all didn't answer the whole question, y'all wouldn't get no points.
I like how SlyFox is doing it, giving up points to different people.
And this is why I'm doing it like this.
Of course you do. That's why I say I see how this goes.
All right, yo, check it out. Let me tell people why. So the reason why I do that like that is because somebody will just randomly raise their hand and then wait for me to finish the question and then go, oh yeah, the answer is this or this, you know. So it's not fair for everybody. If somebody just, first person to click the button, get to hear the whole question before I finish it. So that's kind of to deter you from putting your hand up before the question is finished. See what I'm saying?
Well, you should make them wait. You should say, if I haven't finished the question, and you raise your hand.
Who's showing this?
When I log on to your page to listen to the trivia question, I will keep that in mind. But right now, this is the way we're doing it, all right?
Y'all would be pointless.
He said y'all would be pointless.
Exactly. Don't give no labels.
So the question was...
You ain't right, RB.
Again, the question was, what character said, I see dead people, and in what movie...
Billy.
Milo.
Haley Osment.
Yeah.
As the kid.
Okay. Oh. That is incorrect because I didn't ask for the actor's name. Carmen, what do you got?
His name was Cole.
That is right.
There you go. Carmen's back. All right. Thank you. Cole Sear in The Sixth Sense. And we got
you know what? Make them get a whole name like you make me do. Stop giving out these damn. I don't care if they knew on the show. You know what? If they knew, that show, they don't have no law.
Y'all see why when game shows change rules, why so many people get mad about it? Because of simple shit like that.
Will being sour because he's usually the winner.
He's used to being the winner. He won last.
Carmen got the water. It's gonna get ugly.
Uh oh.
Hey, y'all gonna have to get it together. Let's get these questions rolling.
That's right. That's my man's right there. Okay. Who said? Oh yeah, you ain't gonna get this one out early.
I don't know what Joseph's drinking. It look good.
Hush, chop. Who said I'm the king of the world? And in what film?
Oh jeez.
B-Love.
Is that Titanic? And what's my man name? Damn, Django, dude.
You got one point, sir. You said Django, dude. That's your answer. I give you 1 point for the Titanic. TVV, what's up? What you got?
That was an interrogative.
Oh, that was DiCaprio and Titanic.
Leonardo DiCaprio. You get 1 point for that. Notice that time I did not say which character.
Yeah, I noticed that. That's why I raised my hand because I don't know the character's name, but I do.
It was Jack. Person. Teach me how to spit, Jack.
Oh, okay.
Jack Dawson. All right. Cool. Let's get them hands down. Damn, Carmen, what's going on here?
Calm down.
What's going on here? You got your hand going up, down. All right. Let's see.
I forgot to take my hand back down. Okay.
You good. All right. Here we go. In what movie was the line, "Keep the change, of filthy animal," said, and who? All right.
I don't know. All right, that's gonna be Home Alone, and the movie was by John Hughes. The actor is Macaulay Culkin, and the kid's name is Kevin McAllister. And since you didn't finish the question, I'll probably tell you that Bill Cosby also sold pudding pops. Next.
Well, fortunately, first, I like to give good answers, good question. You're on the board now. Apparently, according to this, which I know how to do the points. If I feel like I made a mistake, then I will retro the points. But that was one answer. You got 1 point for that. Okay.
Which one?
I'm not at liberty yet. All right. Let me finish this real quick. All right. In what movie? I mean, I guess you know which answer you got right. In what movie was the line, "Keep the change, of filthy animal," and who said it?
Oh.
Farrah.
What? I'm taking
a shot in the dark. And since we know it's Home Alone, was it Muggsy Malone in the TV? Was that the movie he was watching?
That was the movie he was watching. But
that's who said it in the movie. Was he was watching a movie, but Muggsy Malone or
not Muggsy? No, no, sorry.
The Fred, no,
Carmen.
Okay.
Carmen.
Yeah, I don't know the character's name. I have to know the name of the character. I just know it was the gangster guy. That's all I know.
Yes, it was the gangster guy.
But that's not his name as the character.
No,
is it?
It's not. Bombay. Oh. What you got?
Are you kidding, Jason?
Are you talking about the gangster's name or are you talking about the name of the movie?
The character that said that.
I'm going to ask the question.
I'm going to call him Angel.
That is incorrect. Jason Michael.
Oh, okay. Never mind.
I'm going to say Cagney said it.
All right. RB3, is it time yet?
Yes, it's time.
All right. It was Johnny. Johnny was the gangster. The actor who played him was Ralph Foody, and it was in Home Alone. So Joseph got the point for Home Alone. Nobody got Johnny. All right. Moving forward.
I'm over the moon for you.
You got one? All right. What? God damn it. B-Love, what you got?
He got his hand ready. That's what he got. He got his hand ready to go up.
All right. what actress playing what part, there's 2 points so far, said, Molly, you in danger, girl. And in what? Jason G.
That's Whoopi Goldberg in Ghost.
G's on the board with 2 points.
Good, Jason. Good job on that one. That was good. You caught that quick.
But unfortunately, that wasn't the end of the question. There is more. So I'm going to go ahead and finish.
People would be pointless right now.
What actress, listen, what actress playing what part said, Molly, you in danger, girl, and what movie was it set in?
But in what movie, what?
What movie was it set in? That's three answers. He got two already.
Said those two already.
Oh, he already answered two of them?
Yeah, he said.
He got two of them, two out of three.
One part that didn't get answered.
Mm-hmm.
And I remember that. I remember that.
You don't remember it? All right. Farrah?
It was when Whoopi Goldberg was inside the psychic's house or whatever, getting a reading, and then the ghost came to her and was telling her, Molly, you was in danger, that she got a reading, she got something.
Well, Whoopi was the psychic, so that's...
She was the psychic. They were doing a reading in a room somewhere, and that's how Patrick Swayze came through the wall and told her that she was in danger.
All right, so Farrah, let me. I understand what my man RBB saying right now. If you listen to the question, it's only three answers. It's only three things that needed to be answered, and two of them are answered. What you got, B-Dog?
Called her goddamn name.
Was it Demi Moore?
That is no, that's incorrect.
All right,
Jason G.
I think the character's name was Oda May.
Yes.
Oda May. That is good job, Jason G. Oda May, there it is. So the question was, what actress
looks and brains?
All right, I don't need to go through it. Y'all got it. All right, listen again. What actor playing what part in what movie was the line said, there's no crying in baseball? All right, Jason G.
Tom Hanks, League of Their Own. Jimmy Doolittle?
Doogie.
Y'all know I gotta go with the first thing I hear. If you would just say Jimmy,
I messed it up.
That's fine. You got 2 points.
God dang it.
The question stands. I finished the question, so Jason Michael.
Jimmy.
Oh,
oh.
That is correct.
And you know you heard me say Jimmy Doogie.
No, but Jason G said Jimmy Doolittle. That's the only reason why I had to like.
He was
fam.
The mic had slipped. Is what had happened.
His mic slipped. Oh.
Yeah.
Okay.
Well, you should log in and get on your own thing. It helps with the algorithm, goddammit.
I'm just a cheerleader. Can I cheer?
It helps with the algorithm. You don't want to help the algorithm?
All right. That is the end of that first round. That was beautiful. Oh, you guys were great. You did great. Oh, my goodness.
Ooh,
that was fun. That was fun. You guys definitely... Don't let people finish the damn question ever. But it's all good. All
first right. Round, no points to anybody.
It's not fun. My hand got unacknowledged twice.
At the end of the first round, Carmen has 3. Jason G. I'm sorry, let me go in order of who's got the most. Jason G has 5. Carmen has 3. Farrah, B Love, Tay, Joseph, and Jason Michael are all in third place with 1. All right, we're going to the next round.
Hey, I didn't know who the hell you was.
Because he shaved?
Where Carmen go?
All right, here we go. I don't know. What is the name of the group responsible for Macarena?
Yeah!
Jason G.
Oh, damn it. Ah, it was on the tip of my tongue.
2 points, what are they saying?
Oh, God damn it. The two brothers. I can't. I don't know.
J-Lo and the Sound Machine.
Bombay's, what you got? Bombay's,
extra points for English translation.
Damn, Los They fucked me up. Yeah. Fuck it.
That's how me and my co-host gonna be when we get old.
Jason Michael, what you got?
I'll just guess. The Troubadours.
I was about to say wow. That is incorrect. Joseph Kennedy. You're muted.
All right. I'm gonna like take a page out of Jason's book. Johann Sebastian Bach and Beethoven.
Woo! Bach and Beethoven would have made some magic, but that ain't the magic that they would have made. It was a Jonas Brothers. What? All right, Tom. That is Tom. The answer is Los Del Rio.
Yeah, no, I wouldn't have got that.
Raise your hand if you knew that one.
I had that in my mind for Benita Talk.
For Benita Talk, yeah, it messes up people's mind, yeah.
Hey, that's how me and my coworker gonna be when we get old.
Oh yeah, I'm trying to. So what was the translation to that?
Is that a question or are you just asking me?
I'm asking you.
Oh, me and you gonna be some perverts. The young girl was talking about she wanted to give her coochie away, and them old men were like, "Is your body do what you want to, young lady?"
Mm-hmm. Really, Ralph.
Really, what?
Why you saying? Keep putting my hand down? That's why my shit never get called on. You stinky funky.
Ain't nobody ask no question. That's true.
When you
have a hostile employee over there.
I don't work for them. He's here. Dude, strike one.
All right, he does not work for us. He only. Yeah, I don't know what he does. Okay.
He's the merchandiser.
Commercializer. He's definitely our commercializer, though.
It'll put your hand down.
Not right, anymore next question. After I'm being treated tonight.
I'll get you a new shirt. All right, the next question. What is the name of the infamous haircut inspired by a must-see TV sitcom? Joseph Kennedy. You're muted.
The mullet.
Ooh, the mullet is a great guess. That was incorrect. Joseph, Jason Michael.
Mohawk.
Incorrect also. Farrah.
Gumby
is incorrect also. B-Love. You're muted.
The Afro.
Incorrect. What the hell did I ask? Jason Michael.
Oh my God.
I already answered once.
Oh, KO.
Exactly. The bowl cut.
Incorrect also. All right. So the question was, what infamous haircut was inspired by a must-see TV sitcom? Must-see TV was a block on I think it was CBS. Anyway.
NBC.
NBC. There you go. NBC. It was the Rachel from Friends.
Yeah. Oh, you talking about from Friends?
Never got that shit.
Oh, man. I used to. Hey, I had all my teachers and when I was in middle school had that shit. And I was like, dude, they look like it.
Yeah. Right. Hey, that was incredibly vague. Like, they would have just had to throw a haymaker in the dark and hope it landed.
I mean, but must-see TV. Y'all don't remember must-see TV?
We just didn't watch Friends.
I thought you said musty.
I thought you said musty at first, too.
Wait. So,
I was like, damn, who's musty? Is it Gumby? What?
Reuben Brown. Oh, my goodness. Yeah, let's run it back. Let's go. All right. What was the first animated feature film to be nominated for a Best Picture Oscar? Jason Michael.
The Lion King?
That is incorrect. Jason G.
Toy Story?
That is incorrect.
I'm sorry, I didn't hear the question.
Does that matter?
All right, well, what is the first animated feature film to be nominated for Best Picture Oscar? Joseph Kennedy.
That wacky ass Frozen?
No. This was way. Oh, this is obvious. This is the 90s. Right now. Right, guys.
Anastasia.
Bombay's.
Incredibles.
That is incorrect. Farrah.
Beauty and the Beast.
Beauty and the Beast is correct.
Yeah.
Telling you when you answer on
your. All right. All right. What year was the World Wide Web first introduced? Jason Michael.
1991.
Very straight to the point. Good correct answer there, sir. All right. Put these hands down. All right, boom. The Dream Team won Olympic gold in what year's games? Jason Michael.
88.
That is incorrect. Jason G.
1992.
92. Yeah. He said yes. Like, I love it.
I ain't got my buzz on, so I'm doing it the best way I can.
Oh, okay. All right, we back. Mm-hmm. Oh, wow. Whitney Houston had a massive hit in 1992 with the cover of whose hit song? Jason G.
Dolly Parton's I'll Always Love You.
Parton. Good job. Good job.
Titty Parton.
We will not deface the Dallas Cowboys halftime show.
Tupperware Tammy.
Who? Macaulay Culkin was paid $1 million, the first child star ever to do so, for what film?
Ooh.
Joseph.
What? Uncle Buck.
Ooh, incorrect. That's a good guess, though. Taylor.
We already had a Home Alone question, so I'm going to go with The Good Son.
Ooh, that would have been great, but that was incorrect also. Jason Michael.
Home Alone.
Good guess, but incorrect also. KO.
My Girl, goddamn.
My Girl is correct.
Yeah. I should have known that.
Now, acknowledge me, goddamn it, when you see that hand.
KO.
Give it on.
Good job, KO.
KO's on the board, y'all. All right, let's go.
Time to attack back.
He said it's time to attack back. Ooh.
Kobe fourth.
What video game was the first ever to be played in space?
Oof.
Jason Michael.
Pac-Man.
That's incorrect. Joseph Kennedy.
Space Invaders.
Space Invaders. Great. That definitely should have been the first game, but that's incorrect. KO.
Pong.
Pong is incorrect. Farrah.
Donkey Kong.
Donkey Kong is incorrect. Bombay's.
Sonic.
Sonic is incorrect. Jason G.
Tetris.
Tetris is correct. Come on now. Tetris.
I forgot. So
it wasn't Snake either?
It wasn't even Snake.
It was a snake.
It wasn't even Snake.
I got to put my head in 80s, 90s. I keep forgetting.
Yeah.
How many points Jason G got? I swear to God, if that nigga wasn't sick, I'd be mad.
Jason G got. All right. At the end of that round, we got Jason G with 8, Carmen with 3, Farrah and Jason Michael are tied with 2, B-Love, Taylor, Joseph, and KO are on the board with 1 apiece.
Because I'm holding it down for Ms. Renee.
Hey, I would take either one. I could be 6'5" or the voice. Either one will work for me.
Hey, he said.
Yeah, but he got them both, though. And he got brains.
And he got brains. And he knows how to make it all work.
He got the voice. Even if he wasn't talking about shit, they wouldn't know it.
Jason G, I'm dark-skinned with dreads, too.
I'm telling you, it's not the voice. It's the microphone. So shout out to Joe.
Wait, what? Ew! KO, shut up, dude. What the fuck? That was horrible. It took me too long to get there.
You just called me.
Way too long, brother.
You just called me. Oh, man.
Okay.
Anatomical parts, KO.
Yeah, that was all kind of messed up. All right. What was the... Oh, that's bullshit. What was the first rap song to hit... Jason Michael.
To hit number one in 1995, it was
Did he feel in his own question?
I'm gonna say parents just don't understand.
Parents just don't understand. It was definitely an 89. It was not a 95, but that's a good guess. I didn't finish the question, but go ahead, Taylor Van Sickle.
My nigga made his own question.
I thought you were done. I thought you were done. My bad. I was gonna say baby got back. I don't know.
Oh, good guess, but incorrect. Jason G.
Oh shit.
No.
I didn't hear the rest of the question too, but I'm taking a guess. Fuck.
Disqualified.
I think so. Damn it.
Oh, summertime. No.
No. Fuck it. I can't. I gotta think because I can't think of any titles in '95. There's. I know the group, but I don't want to get no hints.
There's time. Dude, I just want to go on record and say I never said shit about '95. That was.
I heard '95.
He even finished the question. Bro, my
God, Nelson Kennedy.
I'm going for the long shot here to ESP that you were gonna ask who sang it to, and no. I'm gonna guess it was Blondie, and if that's not right, oh well. I know she had an early rap song.
Really? I don't know.
I don't consider it rap, but there's all these people that are like Blondie made rap.
Oh, wow. It wasn't, but they did say that shit.
Okay, I gotta listen to that one. That's incorrect, by the way. Damn. So, to finish the question. What was the first rap song to hit number one on the Billboard Hot 100 charts? Period. That's it. KO.
Was it Mark Wahlberg? Marky Mark.
That is incorrect, yeah. Sir.
Can you feel it, baby?
Yeah. Sarah.
I'm going to go with Luke. Uncle Luke. Oh, me so horny. Oh.
Hell
so
no. Horny,
bro. I'm talking about the Billboard 100, y'all.
I know, right? Hey, Bombay.
Wait a minute, y'all who answered before the question.
I know, even y'all already answered it wrong. Y'all really can't criticize her answer. Bombay, what you got?
Vanilla Ice, Ice, Ice Baby.
Wow. That is correct.
Actually, they can't criticize her because she heard the whole thing, so she should be right.
Rob Van Winkle is real.
Bro, wow. Bro, my mama whooped my ass.
Was it the show? Rick, Slick Rick, the show.
No, it was Ice, Ice Baby.
Number one, though.
It didn't get to number one?
That's what he said.
Yeah, that's why he got the point.
Oh, what was it?
Well, I was about to say, I'll have to run up on you.
It was dude, Ice Ice
Mom
Baby.
Mom just said it was Blondie.
Oh.
Was... Your mom just said it was Blondie, too.
White boy got the first hip-hop.
I just told him it was Blondie.
Come on, Mom. You can't be... Don't tell him that.
Hey, what's with this Blondie thing that nobody else knows?
I got to go look it up. Like
this, it's a small group of Blondiers.
Rapture by Blondie.
Vanilla Ice put hip-hop on the map. An argument can be made.
We will not make
that. Please don't make that.
He also was the first person to get dangled from a balcony.
Hey, you do what you got to do and drink to number one, bro. Whatever it takes.
I'm mad that it didn't get to number one now that I know that it was first. But I digress. All right. So,
Winkle.
Next question. Wow. Next question. Wow.
Don't hate on Dallas.
All right. What actor starred in two of the top 10 highest grossing films of the 90s? I'll give you, y'all hands those up is fine because that was the end of the question. But I'm going to give you bonus points. You're going to get one for that actor and one for each movie. You name both of the movies. Van Sickle.
Probably Tom Cruise, and it's probably Top Gun.
Okay, that's incorrect.
Damn.
Jason Michael.
Eddie Murphy.
That is incorrect. Joseph Kennedy.
You said 90s. These guys are guessing 80s. So that's
yeah. All
right, good. Just making sure I'm going to fuck up properly. I'll say Tom Cruise again. Fuck up real good. I'll say Mission Impossible. And I hate Tom Cruise, so this is really hard. What else did you fucking do? Barry Maguire.
He's ooh, fine. Good don't guesses.
Motherfucking money.
Good guesses.
Oh, you know what? Now I hear the question in my head, and I already know it now.
Hey, yo, what you got?
Hold on, Jason.
I've got Harrison Ford. Harrison.
That is incorrect. Hard. Farrah.
Lethal Weapon with Danny Glover and Lethal Weapon.
I'm too old.
There's only one character, but there's two in there. But yeah.
Okay, that's incorrect also. Okay. Jason G.
I'm gonna say Tom Hanks, Forrest Gump, in Philadelphia.
That is a great guess. I wish that was right. God, how not? That is incorrect also.
Why you wish it was right?
Nah, because that's a good ass answer. What do you mean? That's a good ass answer. Tom Hanks was killing it in the 90s, bro. Alright, Vincent.
Yeah.
Will Smith, you said 90s, so that's Men in Black and Independence Day.
That is three correct answers, sir.
Let's go.
Good job, Taylor.
Cause we were finna come in there with that Denzel next.
I didn't hear the 90s. I didn't hear the 90s.
If it ain't Denzel, there's some kind of something going on.
For real.
I know him. We friends.
So is that 3 points?
Yes, you got 3 points for that, sir. So you're up to a total of 4. Taylor slapped it one out of the way.
It's the hoodie.
Yeah. It's the hoodie. All right, let's see. Let's go.
Why are you wearing a do-rag? What is that on your head?
Sometimes he wears his head, man.
Hey, you got a do-rag, bro? Oh, okay.
Stop it. I just got off work.
Leave my pants alone, man. All right. How old was the Notorious B.I.G. when he was murdered?
Oh.
Murdered? Jason Michael.
32?
Incorrect. Farrah.
23.
Incorrect. Joseph.
27.
Incorrect. I love the energy. KO.
He was 24.
That is correct, sir.
Okay.
Oh, fuck.
Yeah. 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 All right. Let's keep it going. Keep it going.
Ciao.
Ooh, okay. What year did the Mall of America open? Pop culture indeed. Joseph Kennedy.
1998.
Say again?
1998.
Ooh, that is incorrect. KO.
1989.
Incorrect. Jason Michael.
1997.
Incorrect. Farrah.
1992.
That's correct. Good job. 92. Seen Jason G fight the air. He must have been thinking that too.
I thought it was 90s, but I wasn't sure.
Yeah. Oh my goodness. I hate this. I hate this question. What is considered the first reality show? Joseph Kennedy.
Please don't be Survivor.
It is not. All right, Jason Michael.
The Real World?
Correct. Correct.
I knew that.
Hey.
Extra points, what's the second?
why did he know I was about to give a follow-up question to that?
Go ahead.
What?
Jason Michael,
go ahead.
Wait, can we hear the question?
No. I thought, was he serious or what?
No,
that wasn't RB. That was KO. I'm sorry.
Yeah.
I thought that was RB.
This thing got
going out a bonus.
Okay. For the bonus question, what WWE superstar got his KO?
Oh, The Miz.
Why would you say it, Benita? And you?
I didn't know my mic was on.
KO is correct.
If they can hear you on my mic too.
Hey, it's okay. I do that anyway. I still watch wrestling.
Uh-oh. Yeah.
My son heard that question from the hallway and he had this to say. What do you got?
Nothing. I just heard you say something about
me. What did you do when you came in here? He did the man's pose.
All right, this nigga DeAndre Ayton called in like a real nigga today.
What?
The basketball player DeAndre Ayton called in from his basketball game today saying, "Hey, the road's icy in my neighborhood. I can't come to work." He called in like a freak nigga today.
Hey, let me say this. He ain't gonna miss that one game check. He'll be all right. All right. Ooh. What singer broke her own record for highest ever attendance at the Houston Astrodome in 1995? Jason Michael.
That would be Whitney Houston.
Incorrect. Great guess, though. Joseph Kennedy. You're muted. He's like, fuck.
Mariah Carey is a better Whitney Houston. No, I'm kidding.
Wow. Unpopular opinion and incorrect also. KO.
Selena.
Selena is correct. Miss Selena was killing it in 95. Right.
Fuck Yolanda.
I was watching the news when that happened. when she got shot, I was watching the news at the time.
That's a bad always. It's always fucking
wrong. She stayed but in jail.
I don't know. I can't believe she survived all these years, though. That's crazy to me. But anyway, I digress. Last question of this round. What was the best-selling video game console of the 90s? Joseph Kennedy. Nope, muted.
Oh, sorry about that. Sega Genesis.
Ooh, that is incorrect. KO.
Wait, I thought I was Super before Nintendo. KO.
Huh?
I thought I was before KO.
No, nope, you're not.
Before him.
KO.
Super Nintendo.
That is incorrect. Jason Michael.
Sega Genesis.
Wow.
Somebody else already wow. said it. It's incorrect, though. Farrah.
Oh, shit.
Is it just regular Nintendo?
That is not correct.
No, hey, no, I don't know.
Who wants to hit me up?
Huh?
Yeah.
PlayStation?
PlayStation, that is correct. And Jason G gets
Final Fantasy VII.
But man, you ain't lying. Final Fantasy
I couldn't VII. Even chime in on time. I saw like six hands go up.
Most purchased game in the year it was released than any other game ever released for a console.
That's but really, man. Really sad that the price being higher in the late 90s fucked up the fact that Genesis was so big.
Sega Genesis was awesome. I remember that's the first game console I played Mortal Kombat on.
That was the only console in the 90s that had more titles from the arcade on it than any other console did.
Makes sense.
That's factual.
Oh my goodness, I'm not doing that question. It's stupid.
It's stupid.
All right.
All these people on here, any question's a good question.
Okay, I'm going with it then. What was the name of Inspector Gadget's dog? Joseph Kennedy.
Who would be Brain?
Brain is correct.
My God. Where was his phone located?
Everywhere.
This is a family show. We're not allowed to say that.
Oh, shoot. I don't even know if this is still accurate because of this year. As of 2020, what player had played the most minutes in the NBA than any other player?
Michael Jordan?
That is incorrect. KO?
Vince Carter.
That is incorrect. Joseph Kennedy.
When that
thing, hold on, what year is it?
Wilt Chamberlain.
Well, Chamberlain was my GOAT, but and it's not because of basketball, but that's incorrect. Farrah.
I'm taking a blind shot. Scottie Pippen?
Hell no.
Hell no.
Hey, it was my answer. I need y'all reacting that way, okay?
Farrah. Hey. He ain't scored the most points on Arkansas.
Next. Comments are necessary.
My bad.
It was two people saying that hell no simultaneously.
My bad.
I can only think of two other players that had more play time that I can think of.
Carl Malone.
B-Love. Huh?
Kobe Bryant.
That is incorrect. Jason G.
I'm going to stick with the Lakers. Kareem Abdul-Jabbar.
Damn, Willis. Good job, sir. Kareem Abdul-Jabbar had the most points. That's the reason why I said I didn't know if this year because I think the damn fucking LeBron James is trying to take all his damn records.
You know, Kareem never played off the bench.
You're damn right. Fuck, I look like I'm Kareem.
Even when he was hurt, he never played off the bench.
I should have listened to Lil Dicky more.
For real,
him and Right. Him and Michael Jordan, the only ones to play over five seasons. Over five seasons of 82 games.
Hey, Carmelo has the most undocumented minutes ever.
Man, Carmelo got the most
correct
vibes ever.
Undocumented minutes.
Do his minutes count as Lou Alcindor?
Stop it. Okay, what was Tom Cruise? What was Tom Cruise's nickname on Top Gun?
Oh, come on.
Jason Michael.
Maverick.
Maverick. Damn it. Correct.
Man, I had my window put down.
He said who
asked mine was you? Too.
Alright. Who was the lead rapper for Public Enemy? Jason G.
Chuck D.
Chuck D is correct.
Man, I was so close, Jason G. I love Public Enemy. I still got their tapes. I literally still have their tapes in storage.
Damn. Okay. Who, actor, what actor, who played Will in Will and Grace? KO.
Is that, oh no, that's Kings and Queens. Never mind. I was about to say Kevin James.
That is incorrect, sir.
I mean, King of Queens, that's what he from, shit.
I never watched Will and Grace.
No? Okay. I have seen a couple of episodes, but I never knew who the actor's name was, so time is up. The actor is Eric McCormick. Eric McCormick. Okay. Let's see if you guys really watch TV. 1-800-CRIME-TV was the tip line for what show? Joseph Kennedy.
Cops.
Oh, that is incorrect. Great guess, though. B-Love.
America's Most Wanted.
America's Most Wanted is correct. All right. Let's see. Hands are all down. What TV show from the 80s popularized the t-shirt under dress jacket style for men? Jason G.
Miami Vice.
Miami Vice is correct.
That was good, Jason, because I pondered that one for a moment. Good job.
Okay, Ms. Renee.
Oh, shit. No, Ms. Renee would have said
not even on here enough for you to even say that, so hush.
It was on the I'm saying that's what she do. I'll be that's on the tip of my tongue.
Yeah. I just was about to say that.
Hey, Taylor Swift, we do not make
silently violently broken Michael Jackson's record for ticket sales.
Who did?
Taylor Swift.
Oh, shout out to all
silently broken. Nobody's talking about it.
Okay. Well, I mean,
because she messing with that football Travis. Player guy. Yeah,
the white Travis. Boy can do some things for you, you know.
Man, she doing everything for him. Stop it. Stop.
Yeah.
It.
She the one who wrote his name.
Wasn't she top before all that anyway?
Oh, yeah. Every time she gets in a breakup, she gets higher and higher. That's
yeah,
why.
When she gets rid of him,
she's even going to go higher.
She broke that record 2 years ago.
Oh, shit.
She ain't to be fucked with because she'll write your name.
I can't stand that, dude. All right. What year did 5'6", that's his height, Anthony Spud Webb win the NBA Slam Dunk Contest?
Oh, shit.
Hey, yo.
'91.
That is incorrect. Joseph Kennedy?
Yeah.
1994.
That was beautifully said, but that is incorrect also.
Oh,
Jason G.
Wait, I'm in front of Jason G.
You're not.
On your screen, I am. It got to be on his screen.
Yeah, he was before me, but... I'm gonna say 85.
85 is incorrect. Jason Michael.
95
is incorrect. Farrah.
Oh, 98?
98 is incorrect.
It's 87.
For all the years.
96
is incorrect.
It's 99.
Spud web. Oh. Wait, you already guessed, sir.
Yeah, I was just trying.
You guys forgot 71. Oh, yes, you can guess again. Go ahead.
I know it's the 80s, so 86.
great year. I mean, anybody born in their year is awesome. So, yes, that is correct. 86.
I said 87.
You did say 87. Correct.
But that wasn't the right answer, Kale.
What the fuck?
Why
are you making a case for that, though, is what I'm wondering.
Don't attack my calf, okay?
Hey, SlyFox. Yo. But didn't Spud Webb win it again?
No, just once.
No, he won it one
just
time.
Once that he won it?
He got he beat Sean Kemp, right?
Yeah, he beat Sean Kemp. No, he beat that was
Dominique
the big deal.
He beat Dominique Wilkins, his old teammate.
Yeah, damn.
And then I think Dominique won it the next year.
Right.
Just checking.
Okay.
So who get the point again?
I gave it to Jason G. He came back and cleaned up in the second inning.
Oh, so we can come back and answer these days.
Yeah. There ain't nobody else's hand was up.
Let me drink my maker's mark on you, motherfuckers.
All right. Who won an Oscar for his performance in Rain Man? Joseph Kennedy.
The Dustin Hoffman.
Dustin Hoffman. That's an old
one. Yeah, I had my maker's mark in my hand, or I would have got that. As soon as you said rain, I'd have been clicking.
What if I was saying rain purple? I mean, purple rain.
I like Rain Man.
That was a good movie. He did a great job.
Mm. Okay. Never ever go full retire.
Check this shit out. I didn't know this one. So I'm pretty sure you guys do. What U.S. president said that he forgot to duck when he was shot? Jason Michael.
President Reagan.
That is correct. What is the story behind that shit?
So when President Reagan got shot, there were three shots fired before he actually got hit. So it was bang, 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 and then he got hit.
And he did, and he just was like, damn, I forgot to duck. Like, how you gonna hear three shots and don't get down? You
what was the question?
What was the question?
You missed the question.
Yeah.
What president said I forgot to duck before he got shot?
Kennedy.
No, Kennedy didn't say shit.
How he gonna say that?
Hey, we got 40 minutes. Let's go. Next message.
Okay, my bad. All right, that's fucked up. what flavor was the pie in night? Jason Michael.
I'm trying to move between the freaking button and the pad. I'm just going to say cherry.
That is incorrect. Be love.
I can't see. It's so dark out here, man. I'm trying to be quiet for my son.
I'll wake him up.
Oh, you call me?
Yeah.
I guess I'm going to go with pecan pie.
That is incorrect. Also. Now, the rest of the question is, what flavor of pie was featured in American Pie? Jason G.
What?
Apple.
Apple pie. Because it's like inside of the warm apple pie.
We'll just tell your mom you ate it.
Not really? What it's like?
No. I love you, Lee.
Hell no.
She's great.
Jason said no. Okay, thanks.
If you want Jason G to win, we will log off. Just tell us. It's okay.
Kale, I've never seen you this way before.
I have.
Oh, wow.
You same. Raise your hand when you need to speak to me.
Oh, wow. No. That's not how it works. All right.
Y'all is crazy on this damn thing right now.
Did you raise
this
your
one,
hand?
This one is a fill in the blank. Fill in the blank, okay? According to First Lady Blank, her husband was a hard dog to keep on the porch. KO.
Hillary Clinton.
That is correct.
I knew it.
Damn.
Man, that's what I was going to say no matter what.
I was about to hit Jimmy Swagger next, you know, even though he wasn't the president.
Jimmy Swagger, you already said that today, I think.
Well, I got a question.
Uh-oh.
And tell me to shut up if somebody raised their hand while I'm talking.
Okay.
This popular UK singing group featured five members.
Shut up. Unique. You got to unmute, though.
Oh, that was an accident. My bad. All
right, don't shut up, man.
His popular UK group featured five members. What are their names? And which one left first?
Oh, KO.
Would that be the Spice Girls and Sporty Spice dipped out first?
RB?
I asked three questions and he only answered two.
Did he get any points?
I don't give
points. Scary Spice, Sporty thing. Spice, Baby Spice, Ginger Spice, and
Posh.
Posh Spice, yeah.
Hey, get Tay out of here. You know what?
Get him out of here.
Yeah, get out.
Was that correct though?
It was. Yes.
You mean all of the mouths was biggest?
Was that the point? How many points was that? Three.
Three.
All right, KO. I guess I might have to be on your team for now.
You can't be on his team. You got to be on your own team.
Everybody, hey, what they say, every man for himself. Ooh, I feel like this is a cheat.
Oh, every man for himself, unless it's Jason G.
Unless it's Jason G. He's not beneath.
Hey, Tay with this shave look innocent as hell.
What is the name?
Got that booty.
What's the hit song that Oasis dropped in 1995?
Ooh.
Hoo. Answer.
It's Wonderwall.
Damn. That is correct.
Away.
I thought I was gonna say Champagne Supernova.
I was about to say Cash Express.
Ace Cash Express.
Ace Cash Express.
That's Ace. It's not Oasis, bro.
Oh, my bad.
Damn. All right. Good job, Van Sickle.
Cocksickle.
Who? Who? Shut up. What actor was Nick Nolte's sidekick in 48 Hours? Jason G.
What? Hell no.
Eddie Murphy.
No. I've seen him pop up after me. I put down my church parking lot. His name came up after mine. I seen his head go up after I put mine up.
Hey, you can watch my screen on YouTube once I post it, but.
You got a janky ass screen. I'm trying to told you. Look for the hands to go up, not the screen go. Hold on, let me ask a real legit question. Hey. So if somebody hand up right now, and then I put mine up, mine don't jump in front of this?
Wow. Wow. You've been playing this game for how long, my guy?
Owens, I'm going to have to ask you.
Didn't he just state, woman, that I can't see his screen?
I'm going to have to ask you to settle down because
your throat off ass.
Your actions been having everybody feeling like they can attack my co-host. And I'm good.
Okay. I'm gonna be quiet. The rest of the-
All right. Thank you. Unique. She's laughing. At the child. All right. Oh shit. Oh, I should have used this in the last one. Okay, this is gonna be the last one of this round. What year did Sony introduce us to the PlayStation? Joseph Kennedy.
That year would be 1994.
1994 is correct. Somebody was first in line. All right, let's go with, let me read this. Which 1980s Super Bowl did the Chicago Bears win?
Come on.
Jason Mike?
That would be the Super Bowl Shuffle year, and my father was still alive. And since he died in 85, that would have to be 1983.
That's come on! Incorrect. Jason G.
I believe that was 85.
That was 85. That is the only Bears.
Should I stop raising my hand? That's all I want to know.
Man, no. Who was... I didn't know that either. Who was Princess Diana's boyfriend at the time of her death in 19... Jason Michael.
That would be the prince.
That is incorrect. Is it correct? I mean, only if he would have married her. Joseph Kennedy.
I'm going to say Doty Al-Fayed.
That is correct. That is correct.
What language was that you was just speaking, Joe?
I believe that was Jason McLees.
Jason McLees. Jason Michael said something else. Thumbs up. What's the thumbs up for? You believe in love after love?
I do. Just listen to the rhythm of my heart.
Oh my God.
He's asleep. I got to turn the lights on now.
Which the artist won't be known as Prince. All right. Which 80s duo had to return their Grammy? Joseph Kennedy.
This got to be wrong, but I'm going to say it anyway. Chris Cross.
No!
That is definitely wrong. That is wrong. K.O.
Milli Vanilli.
That is correct.
Fuck. Girl, you know it's true.
Girl, you know it's right.
They called you before me that time. Don't even be mad.
Hey, why y'all playing? That Milli Vanilli be jamming if you put that bitch on.
Yeah.
I'm just mad that nobody realized that they don't sound like that. Like,
God, you're such an old head for real.
I almost
bro.
Bought me a mesh t-shirt on y'all.
Hey, bro, they couldn't be no. Y'all expect them dudes to be that had been singing like that.
For real. Yeah. All right.
But were they singing it though?
Hell no.
Exactly.
This is a four-pointer. This is a four-pointer. What teams did Nolan Ryan pitch for?
Oh shit.
Joseph Kennedy.
New York Yankees, the Dodgers, and the New Jersey Giants.
No.
No points was divvied out in those answers. KO.
The Texas Rangers, the Houston Astros, the Atlanta Braves, and I'm just throwing a name out there. The Cincinnati Reds.
All right. KO got 2 points. I cannot tell you which 2 points he got. Anybody else want to gaggle at that? Well, I guess you don't guess those. Texas Rangers and Houston Astros was correct. And I told you it's a 4-point question. So it kind of gives you a hint on how many other teams are.
Would I be able to go again for the other two?
If no one has raised their hand, yes, sir.
Oh, I'm going to give him a chance, though.
I'm kidding.
Hey, I'm going to use my second round to say the White Sox and the Black Sox.
White Sox.
They got some black ones.
I would have went with the red. I mean, there was Black Sox before, though, right?
Oh, that's what they call the White Sox that year. They got bought by the mob.
Oh, so, my man.
I'll wait for round three.
But that was incorrect. That was incorrect also. All right. I'm going to shut it down. Oh, Bombay is what you got.
Let me go with, what is that? The LA, the Angels, right? This is Los Angeles Angels, right? That's a team. And,
he said that's a team. Sure.
Nah, yeah, that's the team. And, the Toronto Blue Jays.
Hey, B-Lo gets 1 point. There's still 1 point to be got. California Angels at the time, but they were Los Angeles Angels. One more team. If anybody, KO, what you got?
The Mets.
The Mets was the last team. That is correct.
I knew it was an orange team. I don't know why. That's it.
Okay. All right. What famous 90s sitcom star started in a Pepsi commercial alongside Michael Jackson? Bombay's.
Alfonso Roberto.
Alfonso Roberto is correct. I'm so glad you didn't say
that's
bullshit because his last name is not Roberto.
He didn't say Roberto. He said Ribeiro.
Man, I heard a T. I heard a T.
See? I'm going to need to come for me for what I heard.
I heard a T. I just think that, never mind.
How tall was Muggsy Bogues, the shortest player to ever? Joseph King.
Oh, oh.
You're muted.
5'7".
5'7"?
That is correct.
That is incorrect. Correct.
Jason Michael.
5'4".
That is incorrect. Jason G.
I'm going to say 5'5".
That is incorrect.
KO.
5'8".
Incorrect.
V Love.
He was 5'9".
Incorrect. Farrah.
5'3".
There it is.
Yes.
Okay.
Shortest player. That means you still have hope to play in the NBA, Farrah.
Hell no. Cheerleader.
A cheerleader.
Oh, shit. You know what? I was thinking Spud Webb, dog. He 5'7".
Ooh, okay. All right, so right now, let's see what the score is. We got Jason G leading the way with 16. We got KO behind him with 12. We got Jason.
Extra credit. What teams he played for?
We got Joseph, Jason Michael, Van Sickle, B Love, all tied with 5. And Farrah has 4. Miss Carmen, who was no longer with us, had 3. All right. See what we can do here.
I would have quit too if I was on.
Who played the role of 1997's Donnie Brasco?
Ooh.
Jason G.
Johnny Depp.
Johnny Depp is correct.
What movie is this? I can watch it.
Donnie Brasco.
Never heard of.
You never heard of Donnie Brasco, dude? Come on.
Nope. I know the Count of Monte Cristo. Mm.
What? What the fuck does this one have to do with the other? 23 minutes. Okay. Yeah, words. All right. How many children did Mr. and Mrs. Huxtable have on the Cosby Show? Jason Michael.
That would be 5.
That is correct. Get those hands down.
They had an older grown daughter.
Let's get those hands down. Now, bonus point. A point for each in order from oldest to youngest. KO.
Shit. Why you said her name first? I don't remember that wench name. Sandra. Denise, Vanessa, Theo, Rudy.
Damn, that is not correct.
What?
That is incorrect.
It's out of it.
Oh, Theo is older than Rudy.
I'd stop talking, hush, child. Jason.
Hey, bullshit. Jason Michael.
All right, so Sandra, Denise, Theo, Vanessa, Rudy.
That is correct.
Oh, okay.
You stole my answer. You stole my drink. I had Maple's Mark last week.
What?
I love you, Jason, Mike.
Right on. Okay. Cheers, KO.
All right. With that question.
I got you right here, brother.
That question, Jason.
Make Mike.
Right behind KO. So, you make got one.
Mark. Oh, shit. One. Hold on. We can't be friends for a little bit. Hold on.
Okay. Let's see. How many times was Tupac Shakur shot in 1996?
Oh, goddamn.
Jason Michael.
6.
Incorrect. KO.
4.
Incorrect. Beloved.
I want to say 11.
Incorrect. Joseph Kennedy.
I'm going to lowball you with 2.
Incorrect. Unique.
He was shot twice.
Incorrect. Can we just say it?
9.
Farrah.
9.
That was 50 Cent.
Yes. It was 50.
Take a guess at 3.
That is incorrect. Tay.
Guessing at 5.
5. There it is. Damn. I danced around 5.
Man, I was so close.
1, 2, 3, 4, 6, 7.
That was the only number left.
That was the only number. You did all the alphabets.
Oh. I could have sworn it was six.
Two again.
I thought it was six.
All right, check this out. This is an easy one if you've seen the movie. Who played Mr. Brown in 1992? KO?
Dang, man, I was thinking of the other fool, man. Brown. Dang. I was thinking of Mr. Bean.
Who played Mr. Brown in the 1992 movie?
According to an Alexa Answers control. Oh, he's over there cheating. I hear him. Oh, wow. I heard him. Alexa. But KO, see what you do when you answer the question and then don't give an answer, you give people chances.
Alexa, Alexa did it.
All right. Jason Michael.
Who played Mr. Brown in a 1992 film? I'm gonna say
Jawbone.
Eddie Murphy.
That is incorrect. Be Love.
I didn't even ask Alexa yet.
She did. We heard it.
We heard you.
No. She didn't give my answer.
Just because she ain't asking, don't mean you ain't ask her.
Did I even raise my hand though?
Yeah, your hand is
up. Okay, hold on. All right, Mr. Brown. The movie is called Meet the Browns.
Yeah, that is incorrect. KO. We're back to KO.
Was it my man Samuel Jackson on Jackie Brown?
That is incorrect also.
You a damn lie.
Jason Michael.
I'm gonna take a shot in the dark and say Mr. Brown was played by Tom Hanks.
All right, that is incorrect. Now,
can you repeat the question, please? I'm sorry, I didn't even hear it.
Yes, there you go. Who played Mr. Brown in 1992's Reservoir Dogs?
Ah, oh, shit.
Yeah, oh, shit. It
was, but I haven't seen that.
Oh, Be Love.
Anthony Hopkins.
Incorrect. Jason Michael.
I know this. Just
I don't know.
All right, that's incorrect. Farrah.
Not supposed to say that.
I don't know it, but I'm going to take a shot and say, I know it wasn't Nicolas Cage, but what's the guy who played in, I can't.
That's Tom, thank you. Joseph Kennedy.
Random guess, Kevin Costner.
Incorrect.
Y'all don't even know who was in the movie, do y'all?
I was just saying, because he wasn't even, none of these people was in that movie.
Was it Steve Buscemi?
Ooh. No.
Oh, he was Mr. Pink then, my bad.
Stop giving answers. Jason G.
Again, I'm guessing too, but I'm going to say Harvey Keitel.
That's incorrect also.
Damn.
Jason Michael.
Able One Love, Quentin Tarantino.
When Tarantino was the right
fuck. Damn.
That was it.
I just want to say Joseph Kennedy got the best random answers.
His random answers be good as fuck, though. I ain't going to lie. Oh, my God. If anybody knows this, I will give them 2 points just for the fuck of it. What 1984 spinoff of Three's Company starred Jack Ritter? Bombay.
Who's the crowd?
What did you say?
You said, what's the spinoff to Three's Company, right?
Yeah, what did you say, though?
I said, who's the crowd?
That is incorrect.
What?
Jason Michael.
I'm going to say the Jeffersons.
That's
I'm trying to compete there with
I know for a fact the Jeffersons was a
spin-off. Wait a minute, you don't remember the spinoff that came after Three's Company, Two's the Crowd, when Jack and his girlfriend
Jason G.
I'm gonna say the Ropers.
That is incorrect also. Farrah, you must know it because you like keep it going.
Is it Bosom Buddies?
That is incorrect also. Joseph Kennedy.
I got so much laughs from those last answers, I forgot my answer. Move on.
Oh, B-Love's gonna be so mad. Farrah, what you got?
Oh,
Mork and Mindy.
That is incorrect. Damn, I wish you would say last week though, because that was an answer. Jason Mike.
That was Robin Williams.
Yeah.
I'm gonna say two's a group.
Oh. Oh, Jason G.
I'm gonna say three's a crowd.
Three's a crowd is correct. Three's a crowd is the correct answer.
I said, hey, we all don't have a Googling wife next to us, okay? So
nobody Googling, bro.
It was so, I said B-Love should be so upset right now. He was like, he said it. He knew it. He's seen it before because he was like, two's a crowd. I was like, wait, what did you say? Because I thought he's, yeah, damn. Okay. Let's go back to Top Gun. Seems like everybody's seen that. who played Goose's wife in 1986? Jason G.
Oh, let's see.
Meg Ryan.
Meg Ryan is correct.
That was fast.
I knew that. I was just 1 second behind you there, Jason.
That's one of my movies, bro.
He said, I know my movies. What actor played Mitch Buchanan on Baywatch?
Oof.
K.O.
Don't hassle the fucking Hoff. David Hasselhoff.
Don't hassle the Hoff. David Hasselhoff.
Yeah!
Great set of hair.
Great set of hair. All right. What Japanese video game company began in 1989 with playing cards? Jason Michael. You're muted.
Nintendo.
That is correct.
Wow.
Yeah, but that can't be 1989. Nintendo Entertainment System came out in 1995.
That is true.
89.
No, but the Nintendo Entertainment System came out in 85. That's when Mario came out.
It's time travel.
Exactly.
A decade off on that creation date.
Damn. That's fucked up. Video game. Because it was already a company.
So everybody get a point.
Okay, let's retroactively do that. All right, we're good.
The person who answered it first?
Yes, you get your point first, and then everybody else can get one. All right, apologies. That was totally wrong, and I know that's wrong because I had a damn... I was two when I got mine, and I was born in 86, so yeah. Cool. Nice. Good catch. See, that's what I like. I'm going to give out no points for that. Okay.
He knows games, too.
He does. Fill in the blank. Blank's lyrics include, I see no changes. All I see is racist faces. Misplaced KO.
That would be Tupac changes.
Fucking damn it.
That is Tupac. And that was the song, Changes, that came from. Good job.
Don't let him jack you up, smack you up.
And then what?
Oh, him slap you up.
Him slap you up. Yes. Who had an iconic topless Rolling Stone cover in 1983? K.O.
Pam Anderson.
That is incorrect, but great guess all the same. Jason Michael.
Pam Grier.
In 83, I'm going to say it was probably... Whitney?
What?
Whitney ain't never got no topless. She ain't even topless when they was having sex. Come on now. B-Love.
I kind of want to say Prince and on the Avalonia joint. The Avalonia joints, Prince and Avalonia, when she was topless, he was holding her boobs.
That's all. I thought he was like, Prince was on there topless, like, okay. Farrah?
I'm going to take a shot. Guns N' Roses?
Nope. That is incorrect also. Joseph Kennedy?
Dire Straits?
Dire Straits. Wow. That is some 83 shit for you. That is incorrect, though. But wow. Good guess. That's crazy. KO?
Anna Nicole.
Anna Nicole. That is incorrect also. 83 God, is the year I'm talking, guys. 83. Jason Michael.
Blondie?
That's a good guess. Why are you laughing? Because somebody talking about Blondie again?
Because her name is out there.
Go ahead, Van Sickle.
I'm going to say either Madonna or Sharon Stone.
Damn. Two for the price of none.
Probably both wrong.
Two for the price of none.
Yep.
Jason G.
Man, I'm just taking a guess. I'd say Cher.
Great. That's incorrect also. I do love Cher. Now, I seen the video where she was dancing with Michael Jackson and his brother. That was awesome. Bombay's, what you got?
I got Tina Turner.
Wow, great guess. Wow. Incorrect, though. Joseph Kennedy. He's like...
Cindy Lauper.
Whoa.
She better not.
She's so respectable. Don't. No, that is incorrect also. Hey, yo.
I'm going to go with the chick that President Kennedy was born.
Monica Lewinsky.
Wow.
No. What's her name? Start with an M.
You talking about
Marilyn Monroe?
That is incorrect chick. Also. 80.
Carmen Hayes.
I think she was dead by then.
Jason Michael.
Alita Ford.
That is incorrect also. This is going to be the last one I'm going to take, okay? We're going to take this one.
Jada Fire.
Hugh Hefner in the Playboy Mansion, maybe? Hugh was on the Rolling Stones in 83?
That was incorrect also. Now, with the last question I got wrong.
Gianna Michaels.
Go ahead, Joseph. I'll let you get the last name.
I gotta keep it funny. Post Malone.
Post Malone was a baby, I believe. I don't even know if he was
born. He wasn't born yet.
Yeah, he wasn't even born. All right. The correct answer, at least from what I got on this page right here, is one Janet Jackson.
What?
She was only topless at the Super Bowl.
83?
That's not true. She's not even old enough.
Let me look.
Yeah, she was like 16. It was like 16.
Like maybe 93, but 83?
I'm looking at
it. It was like 16. Michael had just dropped Thriller in 82. Michael just dropped Thriller in 82.
I think that was 93 when she was doing Rhythm Nation. And she did that.
It was the album right after 93.
Yeah, when she was doing that video where they were in the locker room.
Ooh. Damn. Yes, that was 93. They gave me the wrong.
Okay, that makes
sense. Nobody said Janet. So
the game is rigged.
The game is rigged.
Keep that out.
No one to get it right. I was learning this on the paper. I was not born yet. Either. Okay, I know this is correct. So let's go with this question. What TV show catchphrase was, "Is that your final answer?" Jason, I'm sorry, Jason. Jason Michael.
That would be, we're talking 80s, 90s, so it's got to be, is that your final answer? I'm going to say Millionaire.
I have never seen a TV show called Millionaire.
So you want to be a millionaire?
That's incorrect. Jason G.
I believe it's Who Wants to Be a Millionaire.
That is it. Who wants to be a millionaire? Who wants to
1999.
Damn, he gave you a chance, too.
Yeah. He gave you it literally.
Hey. It's a game show. We call it Millionaire, all right? Because I've seen they even abbreviate it on the damn TV guide. Mm-hmm. All right.
She's going to have a point for that.
Yeah, how about this? You get this right, I can.
Wait, I thought you were supposed to say who the person who said it in the TV show.
No, I didn't ask that. I just asked what show. But that's a good bonus point. But I'm not gonna ask it now. But
the next question.
Next question is, what TV show was this said? I'm the baby, gotta love me. Jason G.
Dinosaurs.
One of my favorite. I can't believe
that was my shit. You're not even old enough to have seen that.
He's older than that. He was so cute, that little fat thing. He
That baby cute. Was not cute. I'm sorry. That shit was not cute.
Adorable. All of them was ugly. Every single one of them.
Follow up question. Oh, God. The grandma was the ugliest. Oh, my gosh. She was so hideous. Okay. Follow up question. What does the baby call the daddy on Dinosaur? Jason Michael.
Rex?
That is incorrect. Farrah.
Not the mama.
Not the mama is correct. Good job, Farrah. All right. We got 5 minutes left. Okay. Huh. Dana. Oh, hold on. Let me put this down. Okay. All right. On Saturday Night Live, Dana Carvey played a character. Well, shit. Okay. No, you're good. You put it down. All right. Joseph Kennedy, what do you got? You're muted.
Turtle.
That is incorrect. B-Love, what the hell, man? You already had enough to put it down. What's up? What you think? Okay.
My button
on the port. All right. Saturday Night Live, Dana Carvey played a character called the Church Lady. What was her, Jason G?
Catchphrase, I think. Satan?
What was her catchphrase? Satan? That is incorrect, sir. Okay. Jason Michael. Satan.
And the goblin. And may God bless you.
I mean, that sounds about right, but that is incorrect. Joseph Kennedy.
Hallelujah.
I love it. Enthusiasm behind it. Too. Like, that's how she said it. No, that is incorrect. Oh. Okay. We only got 3 minutes left, so I'm going to go ahead and cut this one. The answer was, isn't that special?
Isn't that special? Okay. I knew it had that cadence. I just couldn't remember.
Yeah. That was awesome. All right. Let's see. What movie did this line come from? Snakes. Why'd it have to be snakes? KO.
Snakes on the plane.
That is incorrect. Great guess. Jason Michael.
Indiana Jones. And the Temple of Doom. Indiana Jones in the
original. That's incorrect. Don't do it. Joseph Kennedy.
What is Indiana Jones and the Last Crusade?
That is incorrect also. Be love.
What is Indiana Jones?
That is incorrect. Jason, for the record, there's never been a movie called Indiana Jones, okay?
The first one was it?
Nah.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, Jason T.
Oh, what is Raiders of the Lost Ark?
That is it. Raiders of the Lost Ark. Indy. Wow. They called him Indy.
He stopped putting my hand down.
He never even seen that. He's not old enough.
Dude, this shit came out in 81.
Ice Cube say that in Anaconda.
Oh, that was a good idea. I think someone is cheating.
Huh? Okay, I don't know what was just said. It was a bunch of things just said, but I don't know what it was. What'd you say, Farrah? You got your hand up?
Ice Cube say that in Anaconda too? Anaconda also. Ice Cube said that in Anaconda also.
That was in 2001 and it was not
created
in
90s.
Oh, you're right.
They knew they were there for snakes.
No, but no, they were there for snakes. But
they were there for snakes.
But it was 2001, so it's outside of the.
It is outside of our thing. Okay.
Is correct.
Movie quote. Tell me, I give you 3 points. Movie, actor, and. Hey, character. Fair.
That was an accident. I didn't mean to do that.
All right. I'll give you 3 points if you give me the movie, the character, and the actor. The quote is, "Say hello to my little friend." Jason Michael.
Scarface. Al Pacino. And what was the third thing that you required?
The actor.
Oh, the character.
No, you see my lips is closed?
I think he wants the character. His name was Tony.
So help me God.
I think I'm gonna need to hold one on this one. I think that's too easy.
Tony Montana. My name is.
That is. All right. You got 3 points. I was like, you know, Tony, I think we need the whole thing.
That's Are you talking to me?
I'm talking to me. All right. I think that'll do it. It's 10 o'clock, so I can give you guys the
winner. Yay!
The winner of tonight's game is Jason G. Thank you guys for coming through tonight. Jason G, you ended the game with 24 points. Right behind you was Jason Michael, 15, and KO had 14. And then, you know, we only got to go into
detail. KO, we're in good company, brother.
But let's say this, though. I will have more coming down the pipeline. Me and RB are discussing some kind of brackets to get the best of the best and then end up with a son of a bitch question for the first – the championship, right?
Like an Olympics?
Need
like
some kind of buzzer.
Oh, hey, yeah, we're going to have it. We're going to have it for that. So thank you.
Hey, a son of a bitch question and a Kanye question.
Oh,
SlyFox, just so you know, I put the wrong number on the end and that thing came back, so I'm sending it out again.
Oh, no. All right, that's cool. But you guys, stay tuned. Friday, we got a good one. We're going to have a good one Friday. We already got some talking points on the questions that's been asked so far. Let's use tomorrow to be the last day to input shit that we're going to talk about on Friday because we pretty much got a full show. So,
okay, catch y'all Friday.
See y'all next time, hopefully. Thanks for all the support.
And ask yourself,
Slap,
are you a different animal?
I got something
this
to
Friday, you. Yeah, doing something.
You said, are you a different animal or what?
Yeah, unique. Look into the chat because they posted in there what they doing. I'll just send it to the Matt.
All right.
Slap, I'm going to call you after this. I got something to show you.
All right. I want to hear what RB had to say, though. What'd you say, RB?
I want to see what you're showing.
That's it.
I didn't hear what you said. Somebody
are you different a different? Are you a different animal? Or are you the same beast?
Oh, shit. That's a Kobe Bryant shit right there. I love it. Mamba out!